Sports pregame show. Hello again, everybody, and welcome to 2K Sports. I'm Ernie Johnson. Thanks for being with us. Shaquille O'Neal joins me. In this game, we'll see the Charlotte Hornets going up against the Memphis Grizzlies. And for Memphis, this is their first time facing off this season. Last year, they split the season series at a game apiece. When you look at Charlotte, when you saw them in the playoffs in 2014, you saw just how important Al Jefferson, healthy, was to that team. How far can he take them?
I think he can take them pretty far. But Ernie, they can't be too reliant on Al Jefferson last year. Last year in the playoffs, when he was hurt, he had the hobble foot. They came up short. We all know he'd do a lot of scoring, but the team is balanced otherwise.
The one-of-a-kind insights of Shaquille O'Neal. And now it's time to check in with Kevin Harlan.
Memphis Grizzlies guys, they come in off that loss to the Pacers in Indiana.
It was not a very inspired performance for them, particularly defensively. I thought they gave the hostile crowd a lot to cheer about, frankly.
Yeah, they allowed a lot of free runs to the hoop, a lot of open jumpers, and in the end, the opponent's shooting percentage was right through the roof, and you can't win when that's the case.
All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. Taking a look at the Grizzlies. We've got Damian Lillard. Zach Randolph is out there with Tomić. And there's Carter. And it's Bogdanović in at the two guard.
You know, back in college, Kimball Walker led UConn to the 2011 NCAA championship and was the Final Four most outstanding player that season. Nice to see a winner like him back in the playoffs last season.
Side, Kid Gilchrist. Right side, Kid Gilchrist. Five on the clock. Now the dish to land for three. Here's Jefferson. The shot is off. Some solid defense from Randolph. Memphis with the ball. He lobs it up. Out of bounds. Charlotte takes possession. Now it's in it down to Doris Burke, who is able to talk with head coach Steve Clifford.
The difficult task of defending Zach Randolph. He said, Randolph's especially tough because he's not only a go-to scorer on the low block in the pinch post, but also a guy who can pick up a lot of second-chance points with his work on the glass. He's a 20-10 double-double guy for a reason. We'll have our hands full trying to slow him down. Guys, back to you.
Thanks again, Doris.
Way to play in attack mode and get inside. And you know, if you're on defense and you're going to foul, make sure it's a good one. They did, preventing the and one.
The Hornets shooting their first free throws of this one.
Well, they were 74% free throw shooting as a team last year, so those numbers could come up.
Yeah, as a group, really a dismal year for them from the line last season, guys.
Well, Cody Zeller out of Indiana, the younger brother of Tyler Zeller, who was drafted in 2012. And Cody at 6'11 played center for the Hoosiers. More of a power forward, though, at the NBA level.
Tomić passes to Randall. Oh, yes, the turnaround.
That's the kind of finish we've gotten used to seeing from him in the low post.
The Hornets have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. And as most of you know, Cody Zeller from a family of seven-footers with older, bigger brothers. He had to develop his guard skills and learn to score away from the basket.
You know, Kevin, he actually played point guard on his high school JV team going back a few years. So he has the skills to play the four. He's an underrated athlete, too. And I thought that would be the case, having watched him at Indiana. I like what I've seen from him this week.
The Hornets have gone 2-5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game. And Lamb slams it home.
Yeah, nice fast break from start to finish, guys. Especially on the back end. I mean, he polished it off perfect.
Here's Bogdanović. Feeds to Randolph. Shot from the low block. Offensive rebound. Goes back up. And he gets the bucket. Randolph got his second basket of the night.
The mid-range jumper becomes a pretty high percentage shot for him when he has that kind of space.
And Walker gets to land. And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. Here's Jefferson. Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
Textbook right there. Nice pass, great catch, beautiful finish.
The Grizzlies trailed by three. Lillard with it. 23 points for him the last game against Indiana.
And no question, you look at his assist totals, and they tell you what a nice job he was doing with really spreading that ball around.
A nice shot by Bogdanović.
How in the world did they let him get that wide open?
For Charlotte, they've gone 4-7 from the field, shooting over 50%. Walker dishes the land. Pass to Jefferson. It's deflected. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
Another nice bucket down low. They've really been able to work the ball into the post effectively so far.
Yeah, I think that could really set things up well the rest of the game. Pound the ball inside and let your perimeter players play off your bigs.
Here's Lillard after Al Jefferson scored. Outside Carter. Can't get it to go. Some solid defense from Kid Gilchrist. Doubting for Charlotte, they won that game against Milwaukee.
Well, that one was a very physical game, and it played right into their hands. And a lot of their points came at the foul line.
Yeah, and it also led to a lot of foul trouble for some of the key guys they were up against. So don't forget about that part of it either.
And Bogdanović kicks to Carter. And the three ball is good. Well, Clark, we've seen the lead change hands quite a bit in this one.
Yeah, we sure have. I mean, it's been a bit of a windshield wiper game. I mean, back and forth, the lead has gone 5 times, so no one in clear control yet.
I think both teams feel like they can win. They both have confidence. So we'll see which team can kind of ride the momentum and take control of this game.
And Charlotte again with the bucket.
Well, this quarter has gone awfully well for him. It seems like every chance he's gotten, he's pretty much converted. Memphis really revitalized their season late in the year, but they dropped a lot of games against the Heat early on.
Can't hit the turnaround jumper. For Charlotte, they've gone 6-9, shooting well. Up the floor. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. Moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for Charlotte.
Well, I like the fact they've already been getting a lot of high-quality shots in the paint.
Yeah, their passing has been terrific, too. Clark, we're seeing a lot of assists, really moving, kind of flow offensively. I like what I see. Well, you look at Jeremy Lin, physically 6'5", almost a 7-foot wingspan. Jumps well. He's got all the tools to be special at both ends of the floor.
Catching up on the changes for Memphis. David Lee's checked in for Randolph. Webster comes in for Vince Carter. And Smith subbed in for Bogdanović. And Lamb drops them both.
And for Lamb, really, the only physical knock is that he needs to continue to get stronger, get friendly in that weight room. He's still under 200 pounds, and his high center of gravity means he can tend to get pushed around a little bit, but that's nothing that strength won't eliminate. So the weight room has to be his friend.
A look here at last year in the NBA, where the Hornets ranked. First in fewest turnovers a game, fourth in opponent points per game, and they were top 10 in opponent field goal percentage. That's a good indicator of a team getting it done defensively.
And this is a smart team, Clark, because you talked about the turnovers, number one in the league in terms of fewest mistakes. And that's when they were at their best, when they controlled the action offensively, they were able to execute without making mistakes, and that allowed them to set up their defense at the other end. This was a really well-disciplined play.
And Jeremy Lance gave sort of a late bloomer. He didn't become a starter until his senior year, in fact, in high school.
Yeah, he was lightly regarded. And even in his 2 seasons at UConn, he battled inconsistency at times, but a solid start to his NBA career. Good size and length and shooting ability.
I don't know how how they're going to keep this pace up. Both teams on fire here early. And playing the game on rollerblades, too.
Kid Gilchrist, the screen on Smith. Lamb passes to Jefferson. Tries it from nine. And there's another one for the Hornets.
And you can feel the pattern of this game, guys. They're working it inside, dominating in the paint, getting good shots at will.
Well, four of their last five baskets, guys, have been of exactly that variety.
Tremendous stuff from a guy, Clark, we think more of for his passing.
Yeah, but he's got tremendous leaping ability and a surplus supply, too.
Well, that's a great aggressive move and two big points, too.
Now, here's Walker. He had 13 points in the win against Milwaukee.
And he really kept his head down, withdrawing contact, getting himself to the line. Played an aggressive game. That was a big-time help for him and his team. Obvious foul.
Yeah, he took a hit right there and earned those free throws.
Charlotte shooting their fifth and sixth free throws of the game. The first free throw is good. Cody Zeller, a first-round pick back in 2013, 1 year after his brother Tyler Clark was taken in the first round.
You know, that's happened only two other times in NBA history, Kevin. The Plumlee brothers, Miles and Mason, also taken in 2012-13. Miles drafted by the Pacers back in 2012. And then back in 87 and 88, the Grant twins, Horace and Harden.
The chosen one, he's checked in for Charlotte. The Grizzlies shooting their first free throw of the game right now. And the free throw, no good. Big part of why the Hornets were able to improve so much last year is they had an identity. And Steve, a veteran presence on the team. And that goes a long way.
Well, they've had talent for quite some time, but without direction, it's not easy to make anything of it. I just think getting Al Jefferson in the middle kind of tied all those pieces together.
Memphis has gone 3-4 on three-pointers in the first quarter, doing well from long range. Lee outside. He tries for three. Batum grabs the miss.
The defense backs off a little bit because he does not shoot the ball well from the three-point line.
For the Hornets, you know, hey, they had some low points in the season, but they still found a way to rally around each other and not let things spiral south like they had in the past. Kudos to them for showing that kind of result.
It's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Well, one of the dynamics for this Bobcats team last year is they had a lot of veteran presence, so they're able to deal with adversity, get through that in advance, and I thought that really helped band this team together last year and went on to make the postseason.
And both free throws good for Damian Lillard.
Damian Lillard off to a great start to his NBA career. Year one, he was the fourth ever unanimous rookie of the year. And then year two, his first All-Star.
Sanders' shot is good.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with the way they work down low.
Well, it's become one of the stories of the first half, Clark, just piling up points in the paint.
No challenge from the defense there, Clark. Could have put that one through any way he wanted.
And I love the choice there, partner, going hard to the hoop for that throwdown.
Yeah, that's invisible defense leading to a very visible finish.
And so here's Charlotte. Grizzlies making the shot. Here's Walker. And the foul called on Larry Sanders. That's his first foul. Memphis trailing here. Lillard outside. To the middle. Looking for Webster. He gets it there. Good. Great play by Lillard to set it up. Webster's got his second bucket of the night. And Damian Lillard last season, the first player in NBA history to compete in all five major All-Star events.
Well, let's count them off right now, partner. He did the Rising Stars Challenge, the skills event, three-point shootout, the dunk contest, and he played in the big game on Sunday.
It's a busy weekend.
That's a full weekend, and the young fellow handled himself well in all five of them.
Vince Carter, he's checked in for Webster.
Really good performance so far on the boards for this club.
Boy, I like the way they've done a great job carving out space under the basket when the shots have gone up.
Another lead change. How many of these are we going to have?
I don't know, Steve, but the momentum of this game has certainly swung like a pendulum.
Memphis has gone 3-5 from three-point land so far in the ballgame. Passes it to Tomić. Knocks it loose. Stolen by Walker. And here's the fast break. Walker leading the way. and he finishes the break with a lay-in. And now it's a three-point Hornets lead.
What a nice play. Stole it away and took it coast to coast.
Lillard against Walker. Lillard dishes to Smith. Kicks it out to Lillard. The feet to Carter. There's the triple. Hornets with the rebound. This, of course, their first opportunity to play Memphis this season.
Well, they split their season series a year ago. Remember, each team was battling for a playoff spot.
Boy, he threw out some punishment with that two-hand throwdown.
Well, now's the time to do it. Keep attacking that rim.
Here's Lee. And no good. Trying to use the glass. Hornets leading by five. Batum attacking. An amazing finish with a hand right in his face. Batum's got his second basket.
Again, a few more points added to the lead. They might be ready to pull away here.
I wouldn't be surprised, Steve. As well as they've got it working right now, that could be the case.
Here's Lillard. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Easy call there.
No question about that one. You can hear the impact from where I am.
This is his second trip to the free throw line.
And you look back at last season, he shot 87% from the foul.
Guys, if a game was coming down to the wire and an opponent needed to foul, I mean, he was the guy they wanted with the ball in his hands. I mean, shooting the free throws because of his proficiency there.
The scoring fast and furious as we end the first quarter.
On tap next Friday, November 7th, Paul George and the Indiana Pacers go up against the Boston Celtics. Big time hoops coming.
To start up. And would you consider how Charlotte is doing? Stephen Clark, what are your thoughts?
And I like what they've done offensively, really attacking the rim, getting a lot of points in the paint.
And guys, they've been the aggressor early. I mean, attacking the hoop and getting into the paint, that can make the game really easy for you.
Al Jefferson out there with Batum. It's Jeremy Lamb. Then it's Jeremy Lin. And it's Kid Gilchrist hit the three. So that's who Charlotte starts the second with. Jefferson, no good. Good D by Lee.
And you got to like the defense inside, really protecting the rim.
Challenging shots and making his presence felt around the rim, that's exactly what he can give you.
Let's go to our sideline reporter, Doris Burton. Doris, what do you have?
Well, Kevin, Al Jefferson, a veteran leader, and he's changed the Hornets locker room. A former coach, Doc Rivers, said, you know the people in your life who just bring sunshine? That's Al. He brings it wherever he goes. And guys, Big Al said of his young teammates, I don't talk much, but they really wanted to listen.
Doris, just an easygoing guy. Great presence. Thank you.
And the generous spirit, too, Kevin, is Al Jefferson. I mean, in Utah, he never hesitated to mentor their young guy.
And that's a foul called on Beto Udrih. That is his first foul of the game. And the Hornets making a change here. Zeller's checked in here in the second quarter with a little over a minute gone. And it's Kid Gilchrist penetrating. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. Vince Carter picks one up.
Michael Kidd Gilchrist missing 6 weeks last season with a broken hand. And frankly, he took a step back overall. His numbers getting worse almost across the board.
And a player taken second overall 2 years ago. A lot of pressure riding on the shoulders of MKG.
You know, sometimes guys fall into draft positions that don't necessarily match their skill level. But you can never question the work ethic of this young man. And you know he's going to maximize whatever he can be as a pro because of it.
Offensive rebound. Charlotte in the lead. Here's Lamb. Yes! And a nice assist from Lynn. And it's 8 points for Lamb.
How about the passing here? Moving the ball without any thought, without any agenda.
It's hard to overstate all the points they've scored on assists today. Beautiful to watch.
Second shot opportunity. Hornets with the rebound. Jefferson's got 4 rebounds now tonight.
Well, he hasn't had much success shooting the ball, but it's not too late for him to get it turned around and start contributing.
Lynn's shot is off.
You see the defenders get out of his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the bucket, but not that time.
Ball's not loose. It's stolen by Jefferson. And Kid Gilchrist kicks to Lamb and out of bounds as the Grizzlies gain possession.
Then you look at J.R. Smith. We get a chance to look at some of his stats, how he performed last season. Averaged 14 a game, 4 rebounds, and 3 assists. And you really can't find much fault with him as far as his performances lately.
Yeah, he's been very, very dependable, steady, doing pretty much everything they've asked him.
Charlotte leading by 3. Set up the way in.
Boy, it's been a poor defensive effort. When that ball has gone inside, into the post, they've been in trouble.
Yep, points in the paint, clearly going against them now.
Udrich for 3. That's good. Udrich has got a pair of triples in the second now for the Grizzlies. The Hornets have gone 2 of 5 from the field here in the second quarter, shooting 40%. Walker's checked in for Jeremy Lamb. Here in the second quarter, about 3 minutes played. Down low, here's Zeller, and he makes no mistake on the slam dunk. There it is, guys, that old lady defense. Just watching him go Clark right by.
I think we might be seeing which team is ready to take control of this game.
Yeah, that's a dunk that could absolutely get them going. I agree, Clark.
Shot is good, and the Charlotte lead is cut down now to just 2 points with that basket from Bogdanović. For Charlotte, they've gone 50% from the floor in the second quarter, 3 of 6. Lynn, and he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him. It's going to be on Zach Randolph.
Jeremy Lin, really an attack guard, quick and aggressive, always looking to penetrate and get into the paint.
And Lin has really become an explosive athlete. He's put in a lot of work during the offseason to develop his strength and acceleration. On a different level now than when he entered the league out of Harvard, for sure.
Grizzlies making a switch here. Haywood's checked in. And for Lynn, like a lot of slashers, Steve, turnovers have been an issue.
Yeah, that aggressiveness can work against him where, you know, sometimes he over-penetrates. He's watching a lot of film, trying to learn that balance of when to pass and when to take it all the way to the rim.
The Hornets shooting 61%, showing all the indications of an offense that is locked in.
And another foul would give him 3 before the half, something to keep our eyes on. Kemba Walker, quick, great handle on the ball. He's a blur in transition. And what I like about him, he's always looking to push the tempo for easy baskets, and he's tough, not afraid of the moment.
And Walker, tough to stay in front of, but yet, Clark, he's become a great finisher around the rim.
Well, you know, you have to be able to do that at his size. He's listed at 6'1", which I think is really generous. He's more 5'10", 5'11". And he understands that's an area that he has to continue to expand and add to be the potent offensive player he's capable of being.
He dishes it to Lynn. It's up a 3. And he gets it to go. Lynn's got 7 points in the game.
It was a slow start for him, but he started to take off since we hit the second quarter, guys.
Bogdanović kicks to Smith, and he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline.
This game has been very close in a lot of areas, but rebounding is one thing that they've been able to dominate.
Yeah, they've chased down that pumpkin often.
Fires, high post, Randolph can't hit.
Poor shooting from him this quarter. Shooting percentage nowhere near where he'd like it to be.
Jefferson passing to Walker. Zeller setting the pick for Walker. Shoots from 12. That one off the back iron and out. The Grizzlies trail by 3. Smith outside. Out to the wing. Here's Bogdanović. Randolph kicks to Bogdanović. And there's the call on Cody Zeller. Sanders checked in for the Hornets. So timeout call here. The first for Memphis.
Zach Randolph is a terrific rebounder and scorer. In his prime, you could just mark up 20 points and 12 rebounds a night, every night. He's a little bit on the downside now, but still a player you've got a game from.
That's a two from Smith. And so it looks like the Grizzlies will retain possession here. Here's Bogdanović. 5 points in the game. Smith outside. Tied up here for the Grizzlies. And Randolph, now 33 years old, had that knee injury a couple seasons back.
Yeah, his rebounding remains excellent, but you know, we've seen his scoring wane just a bit, both in volume and the percentages. Not quite the go-to scorer he was a few years back, but still a very effective player.
Jeremy Lin is a bit of a scoring point guard. He's best with the ball in his hands, but not necessarily an elite scorer playmaker. He's trying to broaden out his game so he can play off the ball as well.
Lillard's checked in for the Grizzlies. Kicks to Randolph, deflects the pass, and stolen by Zeller. And now running up the court, Kid Gilchrist pushing it up. The shot's good on the assist by Walker. Walker's got his fifth assist in this one.
That's how you make an impact with defense. Once the steal is made, you know they're going to be scattered. Floor is open. Take care of business.
Yeah, that's right. So you push it. That's the best opportunity for points on the break. This lead, I think, is headed north.
The chosen one, he's checked in for Zeller.
And to become better playing off the ball, Jeremy Lin has to improve as a spot-up shooter. He's actually been shooting better off the dribble, but the catch and shoot is something he'll continue to work on.
Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with Doris Burke. Hey, Doris.
Thank you, Kevin. Steve Clifford, of course, taking over as Charlotte's head coach last season. He emphasized transition defense and rebounding, and their defense was dramatically improved. And he understood the importance of shooting to create space for Al Jefferson inside. Jefferson said he's brought that winning defensive mentality. Kevin, a sharp change.
We'll see if he can continue to move things in the right direction. Thanks, Doris. And the Hornets making a change here. But Toombs checked in. Good on the second free throw. And Jeremy Lin working with a shooting coach, hard to develop his outside shot.
Yeah, he's actually tweaked his release to get the ball off more quickly on his way up. He's still below average from long range, but you know he's going to put the work in. I'll tell you what, for what's really an elementary shot, he looked a little nervous on that release.
Carter, he's checked in for Memphis. Randolph, and he uses the glass on the layup. Randolph's got the lead up to one now for the Grizzlies.
That's the third bucket in a row from the paint. His defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle much more effectively.
Yeah, and until they do, the problems inside are only going to get worse.
Oh, good on the triple.
You know, not only is the game neck and neck and tight, but the rebounding battle is too. Extremely close on the board.
And both teams have really put in a terrific effort down low.
Here's Lillard. Good D by Sandy. Charlotte has gone 1-2 on three pointers here in the second quarter so far. Here's Walker. It's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Well, you know, the Bobcats, after 10 seasons, are changing their name to the Hornets, reclaiming the name of the original Charlotte franchise back from 1988 to 2002.
And for the Hornets, there was broad-based support for the name change. 80% of the fans supported it, and a rise in ticket sales with the announcement.
Alert against Walker. Goes up to the stripe. Haywood dishes to Randolph. Shoots over Walker. And Jack Randolph again. Randolph's got 12 in the game. He talked about a back-and-forth game. This is the definition of it.
Yeah, no doubt about it, Kevin. I mean, not even through the first half, and it's been one heck of a battle.
Well, these are the kinds of games you love. I mean, two good teams going head-to-head, an even matchup. And both sides very competitive, on their toes tonight.
And for this rebranded Charlotte team, the hope is they can channel some of the success the Hornets enjoyed through the 80s, Clark, and 90s.
Yeah, Kevin, competitively and financially. Remember, the rebranding effort cost north of $4 million with new signage and court resurfacing, a lot of fresh purple and teal paint around Time Warner Cable Arena.
Sanders sets the screen for Lin. Back to Walker. Dishes to Batum. poked away. And it's Memphis on the break. Walker against Lillard. Walker goes in. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Walker's got six here in this quarter.
You know, he started out hot, and he's only gotten hotter. He could be in for one of those games.
Walker against Lillard. We've got 1:18 left in the first half of basketball. Shot clock at five. It's rebounded by Charlotte. The Chosen One's got his fourth rebound in this one. And Walker kicks to Batum. Left side Lynn. Back to Batum. Nice pass in here by Charlotte. Then the pass to the Chosen. Can't get it to go. Some solid defense from Randolph. Memphis leading. It's rebounded by Charlotte.
Terrific defense at the rim. They got right in his path.
You know, that's part of what great defenders do. They get not only in your path, but in your head a little bit, too.
Sanders' shot is off. Memphis has gone 7-15 from three-point range tonight. They're not afraid of that shot. Lynn dishes to Walker. He gets stolen by Carter.
Should probably use a little clock here.
Yep, make this the very last possession.
Lynn with the steal. At the elbow, Sanders. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
Easy call there.
No question about that one. You could hear the impact from where I am.
It's his first trip to the line. That one drops. He ties it up. Here is Lillard. He's got 11. But if it goes, what a play! Simply drains it in at the buzzer.
What a big bonus for them in the quarter as he beats the buzzer.
Talk about maximizing every last possession you've got. Right there, it was done.
And we're through two here and a good one. Grizzlies lead by two. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the side. Doris?
Well, guys, I'm here with Al Jefferson, and Al.
Set for the second half of basketball.
Lillard has been playing really well. He's got 13 points and 6 assists.
Let's just take a moment to appreciate the all-around effort that he's put in here today.
The numbers tell the story, Steve. He is filling up just about every column of that box sheet.
Taking a look at the Grizzlies. Carter is out there with Zach Randolph. Then it's Damian Lillard. Then it's David Lee. And it's Bogdanović in at the two-guard spot. Hornets trailed by five.
You can argue that Damian Lillard made another leap as a player last year, building off of his great rookie of the year campaign and taking it another notch higher.
And here we go with Kemba Walker. And Lamb kicks to Kid Gilchrist. And out of bounds as the Grizzlies gain possession.
And here we can check out the story on Al Jefferson. Terrific year last season for him. Averaged about 22 points a game last season. 11 rebounds and 2 assists. And the work that impresses me the most is how he's attacked the glass and provided so much help on securing rebounds for his team.
Yeah, it's huge, Steve. I mean, when you add up the offensive glass work that turns into second chance points, I mean, the rebounding that he brings to the table has been huge.
The Grizzlies shooting their 7th and 8th attempts at the foul line tonight. Good on the second free throw. You talk about players who either love or hate. Randolph, I think, is in his element, quote, leaning on people. He likes to feel other bodies.
Yeah, they love Sebo, they call him, don't they? Nice. He can get busy. Well, I love watching him go to work. He likes to be in the middle. Gets to the rim. Whenever you lose contact with your guardian, he's not the most explosive guy, but he just points out that he can be highly skilled and really good basketball player. Off the charts athlete.
He wears on his opponent,
oh,
doesn't
yeah.
he?
Well, oh, yeah.
There's a lot of attrition.
I think he created that phrase, what was it, grit and grind? Grit and grind for the Grizzlies.
You're right.
And that's how he played.
Yeah. Walker the pass to Lamb. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Damian Lillard. That's foul number two for him. Walker against Lillard.
Well, in the first half, he was flawless when it came to handling the ball, but that has not been the case here since halftime.
Boy, I love it. Active hands on the steal, active feet on the fast break.
And Clark Power on the dunk.
And guys, this is just too close of a game to be giving the ball up like that and then failing to get back in transition.
They get the rebound. Jefferson, count the basket and the foul. Vince Carter picks one up.
Boy, he crashed the boards with purpose right there. Well-deserved second-chance points for him. Randolph never really an above-the-rim player, but with his combination of strength and skill, he remains effective. Deft touch with that left hand.
Lillard dishes to Randolph. Fader on the way. No good. And Charlotte will go the other way with it. 2 minutes gone in this third quarter now. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Damian Lillard.
And that'll be his third foul so far.
And Memphis making a change here. Smith has checked in. Walker against Lillard. And it's Walker penetrating. Here's Lamb. That falls. Nice feed that time from Walker. 14 points for Lamb.
And Randolph is able to post up or face up. And he's lethal either way. Arcing shot of his from mid-range, beautiful to watch, impossible to block. And on that right block, he's doing work down there because he understands how to use that wide base of his to get separation.
Charlotte's gone 2 of 2 from long range in the third quarter so far. And the Hornets call time here. You have to like what we've seen so far from Damian Lillard.
He's been attacking the rim with reckless abandon. They're searching for answers. Some way they've got to figure out how to contain it.
All right, let's go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
I was able to listen in on what Steve Clifford was going over with his team. He was focused on their post play and was pleading with them to try to get the ball into the low post every trip down. The other thing he stressed was the need to be disciplined on offense. He asked for good ball movement and good shot selection. There's still plenty of basketball left to play, and as we watch how these adjustments play out, Cav, it'll be interesting.
And thank you, Doris. And it's Smith missing. Charlotte has gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. Right wing. And Lamb picks the Walker. Outside, Kid Gilchrist. And Lamb. And the shot is long.
I think he was surprised by how much space he had there and just rushed the shot a little bit.
Bogdanović kicks to Smith. They grab their own miss.
Rugged play under the boards. It's not a place for the weak of heart. You got to go in there physically and aggressively.
In the third quarter with just over 3.5 minutes off the clock. To the wing right side. Here's Lamb. And the whistle blows. And it's going to be an over-the-back call here.
Obviously, he's not afraid of physical play, but still needs to play in control.
And he definitely wasn't in control that time. Everybody in the building knew it was an over-the-back call.
Jeremy Lin, he's checked in for the Hornets. And Udrich, he's checked in for Memphis. Smith for three, and it's good. Assisting on the play was Lillard. Lillard's got his 8th assist in the game. The Hornets have gone 4-7 to get things started here in the second half. In the pass to Zeller, stolen by Randolph. Now Udrich, 9 points in the game so far. And here is Lamb. lays it up and banks it in. Lamb's got it all tied up now for Charlotte.
He is feeling a terrific percentage from the field.
To the wing on the left. Here's Lee. No good. Jefferson with some nice deep. Hornets have gotten 5 of 8 shots to fall for them in the third quarter. A nice 62% from the field.
You know, Memphis had a good road record overall. Kept it above 500 despite a really sluggish start to the season and then losing Mark Gasol for a while due to a knee injury.
Memphis has gone 2 of 3 when they ventured outside the arc in the third quarter. Here's Randolph. Here's Smith. And he drew the blocking foul. He'll go to the line for two. It goes on Cody Zeller.
Take a look at some of the numbers last year for Al Jefferson. 9th in rebounding. It became a real offensive threat. Top 15 scorers in the game.
And, you know, in terms of his rebounds per game, Steve, it was really a special season for him. He was a tough, tough physical player on the low block.
Barry Sanders is checked in for Charlotte. And Memphis also making a switch. The quick, he's checked in for Lillard. And Sanders kicks to Lynn. Sanders sets the screen for Lynn. Here's Jefferson. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and 2 shots coming up.
Al Jefferson is really a unique scorer inside. He doesn't shoot a lot of free throws. He doesn't tally that many assists. What he does do is make shots inside while taking great care of the basket.
And Jefferson with the excellent pump fake. Unusual, Steve, in that it really looks nothing like his shot. He just lifts the ball, and defenders always seem to bite on it.
Yeah, you know, it's that deception. And sometimes it looks, you know, almost comical, and yet defenders go for it. So it's obviously an effective move. And I think it's also his mentality. He's trying to trick defenders and elude them instead of, you know, trying to draw contact.
Here's Lamb. Yes! And a nice assist from Lynn. Lynn's got his 3rd assist on the night. And an important part of every team's game. A look at the hustle stats for the Hornets.
Their high-energy defensive effort has paid off for them, guys, with more than a few steals over the course of the ballgame.
And they're also really getting out in transition and scoring some hoops in the fast break tonight.
Sanders sets the screen for Lynn. Off the screen, Lamb, good. Lamb's got 20 points.
You know, of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is major smash-mouth basketball, guys.
Love it. Old school. Just physical play in the paint. Dominating.
Boy, what a slick job of passing from Jeremy Lin on that
one. The Grizzlies trailed by 4. Pass to Harrison. He in the post. Defended by Jefferson. Puts up the baby hook. Indy, Lee drops it in. Lee's got 4 points in the quarter.
That time the defenders were a little lazy getting to him.
He's got 9.
That 4 foul might force him to scale back the aggression defensively a little bit. He does not want to pick up number 5.
We've watched Lamb play great basketball. He has 20 points. He's picked up 6 points from behind the arc.
His outside stroke has looked really good today.
The chosen one, he's checked in for Charlotte. Batum comes in for Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. Bogdanović, he's checked in for Memphis. Damian Lillard comes in for the quick. Lillard dishes to Randolph, and a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here.
And no question, he got bumped on that shot.
Definitely no room for discussion on that one.
He'll take his 3rd and 4th free throw shots of the game right here, and Randolph drops them both.
The story in the first half was their low free throw percentage. They've corrected that here in the second half, and hopefully they can build on it as this game continues to progress.
Lynn kicks to Lamb. And the pass to Sanders. Lamb up top, all sorts of time, and he hits the jump shot. Lamb's got 24 points.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the league.
Timeout called. The Grizzlies. And as we get a break here, important for the teams to go over their own strategy. And for the players, this is where you have a chance to get rehydrated with Gatorade. So put out your best effort as the game wears on, guys.
You know, it's amazing when you're playing during the season, if you go through a stretch where you don't hydrate, it can have a major physical toll on you. Your body wears down quicker, you don't recover as fast, and that can really take its toll over the course of an 82-game season.
Lynn with it. Lillard picks him up. Screened by Sanders. Grizzlies with the rebound.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
Nice shot by Smith.
I like the offensive awareness to exploit that lack of coverage on that play.
Charlotte in the lead. Outside, Lynn. He feeds it to Sanders. To the paint. Here's the chosen one. Oh, and there's the one-handed jam.
Rising high to throw that one down.
Sky high. Fantastic one-hand jam.
Yeah, what a way to wrap up that possession.
There's the bucket. Good.
They're getting a bunch of their points outside of the paint. Three of their last five buckets are from three-point range.
But the defense isn't making them earn it. And those shots have just come on easy, open looks.
Double by Smith. Sanders kicks to Lynn. Charlotte moving it around. Batum for three. Bogdanović grabs the miss. Bogdanović has got his third rebound tonight. That's a two from Lee. And the Grizzlies tack on two more.
This game has taken on a new feel since halftime.
For sure. The energy level on both sides has gone way up after the break.
To the left side wing. Batum sets a screen for Lamb. He kicks it to Sanders. Pocket six. There's the dish to Batum. Here's Lynn. Bangs home the trifecta. Lynn's got 12 points in the game.
And Clark and Steve, as we approach the fourth quarter, still anyone's ballgame.
Yeah, exactly right, Kevin. I mean, these teams just simply keep trading baskets, and as a result, trading the lead.
Yeah, neither side really able to create much of a cushion at all. So which team can make a little run here? We'll see.
He can fly, can he? He'll make you forget he's a point guard sometimes.
Yeah, when he does decide to attack the basket, Kevin, he can do it with the best of them.
And this is the time to attack with these two teams locked in such a close game.
Feeds to Lee. No one near Smith as he lets it go. They get it back. Tomić tries again. That one rolling around and rims out. Here comes Lynn. 12 points for him. Makes it off the glass. Lynn's got 5 points now this quarter.
Late reaction from the defense, and he's always going to make good on that.
Just 4 seconds left to play in the third. Lillard from outside. No good trying to beat the buzzer. And at the close of the third quarter, still a close game in both teams.
Are on the court all the time.
Charlotte has gone 4 of 8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here.
Zeller and Johnson are the bigs.
Kemba Walker is out there with Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. And it's Batum in a 3 spot. So that's the lineup for Charlotte.
I like his tenacity getting to the basket there, even though the dunk rattled out. 99 times out of 100, you'll get the dunk or the foul.
Walker against Lillard. It's up a three, and that one's good. Lillard's got the first basket as we get going in the fourth for Memphis. And now we'll get perspective here on how the hustle game has been going for the Grizzlies.
Their activity at the defensive end, Kevin, has been really impressive. Attacking and coming away with steals.
Another factor here tonight has been the amount of points they've scored off turnover.
Jefferson's shot is off.
Boy, they almost tied it up with that shot.
Boy, they're this close here in the fourth quarter. trapping back into it.
This has been a terrific contest up to this point, and I would guess it's going to stay this way all the way to the end. Great matchup.
Probably so. Neither team wants to give an inch.
And it's Kidd Gilchrist penetrating. And oh, here we go. Lillard's got it, the fast break chance. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
Boy, how's that for a quick possession?
Yeah, it sure was. I mean, he didn't waste any time getting down the court, did he?
Here's Walker. Bounces high off the rim and drops.
Unstoppable offense from both teams. I love the pace this game has been played at.
So does everybody else in the building. This has been a fun one.
Batum with the steal. Pass to Walker. Soft touch off the glass.
What's going on defensively there? A lack of focus, no concentration. Too easy.
Walker against Lillard. Pass to Tomić. Shot is off. Jefferson with some nice deep. For Charlotte, they've gone 2-4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time, the whistle blowing. It's not very often you can say this about the future is looking pretty bright and short.
So often the season ends and you're thinking about the issues you've got to deal with, but right now the Hornets headed in a good direction.
Artel Webster, he's checked in for the Grizzlies. Rudrick comes in for Bogdanović.
And for Charlotte, as you said, you know, part of it is feeling good with their direction, but also it should feel good that they actually have a direction after the way the last few years have been.
No good from Lee. Charlotte has gone 4 of 8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here. Here's Kidd Gilchrist, and it's rejected. They recover it, and he gets it to go. A little over 2.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth quarter. Back to Lillard. Some nice passing there by Memphis. And the basket by Webster.
You know, having a direction, as you mentioned, had been a problem with Charlotte because they seemed to change their minds every year about who they were going to be. They did it for the last decade or so. Now it seems as though the base is solid and they've got an idea of how they want to build and who they want to build around. And they've got a group that can grow together.
Looking at who's out there now for the Grizzlies. Zach Randolph's checked in for Lee and it's Carter in for Webster. And now Doris Burke has an update from the sideline.
I was able to listen in on what Steve Clifford was going over with his team. He tried to really fire them up to bring it home, saying, all night, you have all night to rest after the final buzzer. For now, we have to lay it on the line and try to bring it home. Guys, back to you.
It was great to hear from you, Doris.
They've been splashing home those three since halftime.
Definitely a big improvement in their shooting from what we saw before the break.
Took him no time at all on that one. Carter's got it all tied up now for the Grizzlies.
Incredible. Only took them a few seconds to answer the three ball with one of their own.
Let's keep this thing going, guys. I love seeing a three-point battle like this.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Damian Lillard. That's his fourth foul of the contest. Jeremy Lamb's checked in for Nicholas Batum. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Damian Lillard. That's his fifth foul.
Boy, it's been a tough go in terms of fouls for him. And my goodness, he can't stay out of the way of fouls.
And out of bounds as Memphis gains possession.
I'll tell you what, that's just a major unforced error right there, guys. My goodness.
Zeller grabs the board. Zeller's got 7 rebounds in the game. Walker the pass to Kidd Gilchrist. Walker dishes to Lamb. Back to Walker. The feed to Zeller. Outside, Walker. Shot clock at 6. Throws it from outside. Walker's got 10 points now just in this quarter.
He's been hot here in the fourth, contributing big at the right time.
Well, he's basically hitting everything he's throwing up there. 4 for 4 shooting here in the quarter.
And Tomić kicks to Udrich. Lillard from outside. That's good. That's Udrich with the assist that time. 25 points for Damian Lillard.
Right now, the defense needs to do a better job of closing out on this guy. He's heating up from outside.
Jefferson setting the pick for Lamb. Back to Walker. Wide open look. And Charlotte again with the bucket.
He is just tearing it up this quarter. That lead's not going anywhere while he's this hot.
And Udrich kicks to Lillard. Lillard again missing. Charlotte has gone 2-for-2 from three-point land to start the fourth quarter. Walker with it. Lillard picks him up. Kicks it to Lamb. Somehow ignores the tight D and gets the layup. And now a four-point Hornets lead for Memphis. They've gone 6-for-13. So just above 46% on their field goal attempts here in the quarter. Dishes to Carter. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. Zeller. And so he's picked up his final foul. And he will sit for the rest of this game. And the Hornets making a change here. Sanders has checked in.
You really have to like the work they put in at the free throw line here in the half. I mean, they've been really aggressive in drawing fouls. And then they've been able to knock down their free throws.
Vince Carter in his day, one of the most electrifying players in the NBA, superstar in Toronto, one of the all-time great highlight reel dunkers. Those days are behind him, but he remains a very valuable and, at this point, maybe even underrated NBA player.
Kid Gilchrist with the steal. And a fast break now for the Hornets. Walker's running. Here's Lamb. That falls. Nice feed that time from Walker. And that's now 28 points for Lamb.
And for Vince Carter, a quality defender and still a well-rounded contributor. He's had a nice breadth of skills. Now he does little things to help him.
This guy's really flowing with his stroke right now. He hit one earlier, and now he has three in this half.
Walker the pass to Lamb. Away, and that'll be Charlotte as it goes out of bounds. Hornets retain possession. And for some superstars, they have a tough time accepting Clark a lesser role. I've Vince Carter.
You know, it's really impressive the way he's gracefully aged into becoming a quality six man, Kevin. I think it's a model for other aging superstars or former superstars to follow. Al Jefferson is the mayor of the left block. Has that signature right-handed jump hook, which is virtually impossible to stop. Kind of like a one-handed push shot, if you compared it to anything, but with his size and really high release, it's still hard to get to if you're defending.
And Jefferson can really palm the basketball. Big hands. Don't you think that helps his control in that jump hook?
Oh, yeah, no question. The ability to gather and go up with one hand, you know, leaving the other hand free to ward off the defender. It's a big reason why he's got such a low rate of turnovers for a go-to scorer down on the block.
And guys, here in the fourth quarter, still a close game.
Yeah, and actually still too close to call. I mean, this one is tight.
This could be an instant classic, fellas. I mean, this thing has all the looks of a game that's going to go right down to the last shot.
And that one's good.
Well, he couldn't have picked a better time to get on a roll like this.
Yeah, that's big time, Steve. I mean, he's hit six straight here in the fourth quarter in a close one. That's legendary type stuff.
He hasn't been quite able to lure the defense into fouling him as much. Hasn't been as effective in drawing fouls here.
The throw good, Damian Lillard. And both free throws good for Damian Lillard.
He's a dead eye at the line, fellas. Just call him automatic. He doesn't miss many of those.
Against Lillard and stolen by Lillard. A finish.
Oh, hammer time. Hammer time. Talk about putting something extra on it. That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, Clark, and he's going to finish firm when he gets the space.
Still, I mean, startling that he'd even try that right now.
It's tipped. Inside, Tomić, and he takes the fantastic lead pass up strong for the slam.
Textbook textbook example there of how to use defense to create offense.
Yeah, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
Yeah, it feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close.
They grab their own miss. Here's Kidd Gilchrist off target at the rim. And the Grizzlies leading by five. The try by Smith. That one falls, coming off Carter's feet. 18 points for Smith.
They are not rotating nearly quickly enough on defense down low. Got to get quicker there.
And even if it costs them some foul trouble, I mean, they need to start putting some bodies on bodies. Be physical.
Shots good by Walker.
Points just keep coming for him this quarter. Just at the right time, too, as they try to narrow the depth.
David Lee's checked in for Memphis. But Quick comes in for Damian Lillard. .153 left in the game. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
For the Hornets, they've really struggled against Smith.
He has 18 points, and he's drained four three-pointers here as well.
With more to come, maybe. The way his shot looks tonight, it's like he's in for a big time.
So he goes 2 for 2 at the line. And it's a 7-point game.
And the lead now pretty healthy after that trip to the line.
A minute 50 left to play here in the fourth. Walker dishes to Jefferson. Back to Walker. Jefferson setting the pick for Walker. Pass to Jefferson. 11 feet away, and that one's good.
His shooting has been so good today, he may have to take it upon himself to try to get his club out of this hole.
Memphis leading by five. Now Lee inside, and he slams it one-handed.
Oh, Maestro, he is so good at making those lead passes, like conducting an orchestra.
Charlotte's gone 6 of 11 when they're taking the three-point shot tonight. Very respectable. Walker with a clean look. That three off target. Had some space there after the little pump fake. Got a piece of it. And there's another one for the Hornets.
He has not lost his focus today. Even when things haven't gone his team's way, he's still bringing it.
Memphis has gone to three-point range for 12 of their points in the final quarter on 4-5 shooting. Carter gets the lead. With the fadeaway. That's in there. Carter with the assist. Lee's got the lead back up to 7 now for Memphis.
Boy, beautiful assist. That's a couple of teammates clearly on the same page.
Outside, Walker. Here's Lamb. From outside, off the mark. And for Memphis, they're shooting 53% from the floor. They're locked in. There's Lee with the three. Again, the miss by Lee. Charlotte has gone 2 of 5 on three-point shots since the end of the third quarter. And Walker kicks to Jefferson. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. J.R. Smith picks one up.
We watched Jefferson play great basketball. He's got 10 rebounds, and he's added a steal to his stat line also.
Now that's obviously not a big number, but he's been doing some valuable defensive work for him.
That's good. Going 1 of 2 from the line, and that trims the lead to 6.
I'm sure he'd like that miss back. Hard to chip away at a lead, leaving points at the line.
And an intentional foul right there. That's the first. That makes it a 7-point lead. And so he drops them both. It's an 8-point game. And the Hornets with possession here. And it would take divine intervention for them now to get back in it.
And even that might not be enough.
Yeah. Steve, what do you think?
No, I don't see it. Very little chance of a comeback. I think this is over.
Well, this one is winding down now. Memphis can watch the clock run out. Poked loose. Kidd Gilchrist with the steal. And here we go with Kidd Gilchrist heading to the hoop. And that one is stuck right through. The rim rattler.
Just a remarkable jam. These fans' jaws are on the ground right now.
Yeah, that is showtime stuff right there. Major highlight reel material.
And they go to the intentional foul. So the first one drops, and that makes it a 7-point lead. He he's off on the free throw, unable to get that second one to drop in. Here's Roberts. So it's Memphis picking up the win. It was a solid win, Clark.
Yeah, it was, and I think it came down to will more than skill. They went out and got this one.
And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Thank you, Kevin. I'm here with J.R. Smith. This team really looked good tonight. What was the key out there?
Our penetration was unbelievable tonight. Everybody was penetrating the ball. We weren't settling for jump shots and contested jumpers. And as long as we keep moving the ball, we'll be fine.
JR, appreciate the time as always. Kevin?
Doris, thank you. And for...